Good morning.
Morning.
Happy Mother's Day. And happy Christian Family Sunday. Today we especially celebrate the mothers in our lives, and we celebrate that we are united as a family of God through Jesus Christ. And I welcome you all, those here in person, also those of you who are watching online. Greetings to you today. And today, it may not get said later in the service, we remember today many people who can't be united with their mothers because of COVID. But we give thanks that there are other means of being able to be in touch and to express love and gratitude for mothers. For the life and work of our congregation, I commend to your bulletin the inside of the back cover, page 6. The men's club are having a flipper supper takeout on May 24th. From 4:30 to 6, and I think the tickets are selling quite nicely, so but please note all tickets need to be purchased beforehand, and you can contact the church office Monday to Friday from 9 to 12 to make sure you book your ticket. And there won't be any exchange of money at the event, so you do need to book your ticket and pay for them in advance. Also, on May 28th, Spring Has Sprung, we're having a virtual concert, from people from our congregation and our choirs. So again, it's through Eventbrite, and the information you can be found in our bulletin, will be in our webpage and Facebook page as well. Also, join us for virtual coffee hour on Wednesday, 10:30. And also note, George Street are having turkey teas. And I also need to a couple more announcements. One is that this afternoon, I think 4:30 Newfoundland time, and the link is found on our Facebook page. United Church of Canada will have a special service this afternoon, led by our moderator, the Right Reverend Dr. Richard Bott. And this is a service to commemorate the apology that United Church has made to mothers whose children were, I guess for lack of a better word, forcibly removed from them many years ago and placed for adoption in homes that were run by the United Church. And so today there will be a service to commemorate that. And it's at 4:30, and it will be on YouTube. So if you can't make it at what might be dinner time, please have a look later. Also, First on Eastern Edge, our regional meetings are coming up next weekend, and attached to that there is a youth forum, and their theme is Presence and Hope, Climate Justice. So it's on the 14th and 15th, and in your bulletins today is this green insert, and there is also the place to register online. And I know we have some youth here today who are junior high and high school age. So please consider that. I went last year. I snuck in, even though I wasn't a youth. And they have lots of fun activities and games. It will be via Zoom, but please consider it. I think those are my announcements. I also know we have one birthday this week for sure, and that's Sarah. Happy birthday. How old, Sarah?
I'm going to turn 10.
I'm going to turn 10. Awesome. Double digits. Kind of remember that far back. Anyone else? any birthdays or blessings or to share? Not? Anyway, I should. I'll light the Christ candle as a remembrance to us that the light of Christ who unites us is with us today and lights our way. And in following that, I should have said too, especially for those who are online, today much of our service will be led with the talents of our children and youth. And following lighting the candle, Christopher Clancy is going to share in our call to worship.
Parents and children, siblings and cousins, grandparents and greats, aunts, uncles and more.
Family in God's love.
By adoption, by choice, by birth or just because.
Family in God's love.
People well known, people never met, people near, people far.
Family in God's love. Come as you are. Come as you will be. Come and worship all who are family in God's love.
Shared in the bread and the wine, we are the bread. us, and we are bound.
Thank you, Brett and Rachel, and also I should say thank you to Jillian for our accordion preludes earlier as well. We are blessed with so much talent here. And Chelsea is going to come and lead us in prayer.
Father, Mother, Father God, Brother Jesus, Sister Spirit, we gathered this morning in brilliance of a new day. We gather to sing, to pray, to hear. We gather to be inspired. Come, come, sit with us, join us. Amen.
Friends, the wonderful news is that God does come and is with us through Jesus Christ, uniting us and loving us and inspiring us. Brianna.
Peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Can everybody just take a little sip to say hello to your neighbor?
Peace, everyone. Leave us in our litany for mothers.
Mothers come in all different forms, and today we celebrate them all.
Thank you, God, for mothers.
Everyone here is either a son or a daughter.
Thank you, God, for my mother.
For every mother who have joined God in heaven and whom we miss dearly here on earth.
Thank you, God, for mothers of the past.
For each woman who is working day and night to raise her children right now.
Thank you, God, for mothers of today.
For the women who are expecting but aren't quite mothers yet.
Thank you, God, for the soon-to-be mothers.
For the women who care for children through adoption and foster care.
Thank you, God, for the mothers with hearts so big.
For those women who have lost a child to death and must carry on.
Thank you, God, for mothers who are so strong.
For all the women who have wanted to have a child but chose to mother everyone else instead.
Thank you, God, for mothers in spirit. We thank you, God, for women who have mothered us and have influenced our lives in so many ways. We pray that we will honor them in everything we do. Amen.
Rachel Morris will inspire us again with the wind beneath my wings. And Naomi Bungay is going to surprise us with a little artwork.
This is a gospel reading from John chapter 15, verses 9 through 17. I've loved you the way my Father has loved me. Make yourselves at home in my love. If you keep my commands, you'll remain intimately at home in my love. That's what I've done. Kept my Father's commands and made myself at home in his love. I've told you these things for a purpose, that my joy might be your joy and your joy wholly mature. This is my command. Love one another the way I loved you. This is the very best way to love. Put your life on the line for your friends. You are my friends when you do the things I command you. I'm no longer calling you servants because servants don't understand what their master is thinking and planning. No, I've named you friends because I've let you in on everything I've heard from the Father. You didn't choose me, remember? I chose you and put you in the world to bear fruit. Fruit that won't spoil. As fruit bearers, whatever you ask the Father in relation to me, he gives you. But remember the root command, love one another. Praise be to Christ, the living word.
Carly Grandy is going to lead us in our responsive song, and I invite you to stand for the reading of the psalm as you are able once Corinthians.
Psalm 98, found in Voices United, page 818, the response will be sung.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
Sing to song. Sing to God a new song.
For God has done marvelous things.
Your right hand and your holy arm have brought victory.
You have made known your salvation and revealed before the nations your saving power.
You have remembered your steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God.
Make a joyful noise to God, all the earth.
Break into joyous praise. Sing songs.
Sing songs to God with the harp.
With the harp and melodious voice.
With trumpets and the sound of the horn.
Make a joyful noise before our sovereign God.
Let the sea roar and all that fills it.
The world and its inhabitants.
Let the rivers clap their hands.
The hills sing together for the joy before God.
You come to judge the earth, O God.
To judge the world with righteousness and the peoples of equity.
Glory be
to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Thanks be to God.
Friends, today as we celebrate that we're family, but we especially celebrate and remember our moms. And I know there are a few younger than average humans here today. And I'll ask them first, and anything to do? Did anyone do anything special for mom yet today? Yeah? What was that?
A rose out of paper, like folded paper. Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's it. And breakfast
and a homemade rose. Awesome. Anyone else? Any breakfast in bed over here? Oh, Wanda got breakfast in bed? Oh, awesome! Every Sunday! So all your mothers know where to go? Go to Wanda's. Wanda's, there's Mother's Day every Sunday. Anyone else? Anything special? After church? It's a long day yet. But you're all on the book now. Anything special that you might have learned from your moms? Anyone have something special or special remembrance? No? Sometimes it might be too personal, but unlike some of you here, my mom has passed away a number of years ago. But I learned a lot from my mom. Some of it was funny, some of it was not funny. And she wasn't particularly funny when I did something that she didn't approve of. But I learned a lot from her. And I tell you, one of the things that I learned from my mom from a very young age, and I saw her exhibit it right to the very end, just before she wasn't able to communicate, but her, even one of her last final gestures was of kindness and generosity. And that's a lesson that I've learned, and sometimes I'm not sure I always live up to it. And when I'm not particularly kind, I kind of can hear her, right? Do you have messages from your mom like that sometimes too? Yeah. I want to share a story with us today, because today we're talking about our moms, but we're also talking about that we are a family. Like our first hymn this morning, come in and sit down, because we're all part of God's family, and of how we live into that. And the gospel reading that Leslie shared with us today was about Jesus telling us to live in love, that we to love one another. And one of the ways we live in that love, and if we show that love, then we show that we are a family together. And so one of the ways of showing love is kindness. And so I have a book today, and I want to share it with you. And it's called Kindness Grows, and it's by Britta Teckentrup. And it shows us what happens when kindness grows, but it also shows us the other side of it as well. It all starts with a crack that we can hardly see. It happens when we shout or if we disagree. So you'll notice on some pages there are cracks. But with every kindness that we show, something good and magical will begin to grow. Friendships can be damaged by a mean or ugly word. Once it has been spoken, it cannot be unheard. Words of encouragement, sweetness, warmth, and care blossom, grow, and flourish as they spread love everywhere. If you leave friends abandoned, sad, and on their own, soon the crack will widen and will be left alone. Sharing things with others, making a new friend, will begin a journey we hope will never end. It's so hard to be friendly when all we feel is sad. Sometimes we are thoughtless and we make others feel bad. But a kindly thought or action can make somebody's day. If we keep our friends close by, we won't drive them away. When we argue with each other, or we refuse to share, the crack grows even wider, but we don't know that it's there. Playing all together is always much more fun. We have a lot of space here for each and everyone. Sometimes we are selfish. We stomp and stamp our feet, feeling annoyed and angry with everyone we meet. But when we work together, just look at what we can do. Anything is possible when 1 + 1 = 2. Anger can consume us until we just can't see the beauty that's around us, the moon, the stars, a tree. If we lean on one another and keep our friends around, we make each other happy, warm, and safe and sound. The crack has grown so wide now, can we ever make things right? If we reach out to others, then maybe we just might. If it only takes a gesture, a smile can be the start to spread the seed of friendship and touch somebody's heart. Reaching out to others is not as difficult as it seems. If we all join together, we can chase our dreams. Our tree will grow much stronger the more we show we care, built from love and kindness and the friendships that we share. Amen. So that tells us that as families, as friends, and as church, that we live in kindness and watch out and take care of each other, be mindful of how we treat each other and how we talk to each other, then we grow into something that is beautiful, and that we grow and live in that love that Jesus taught us how to love. And I know that seed is planted with us, and that it will grow into something beautiful, even more beautiful than it is today. Thanks be to God for love and kindness and grace. Amen. Sarah is going to sing for us today, I think. Butterfly, fly away.
Give thanks for them in song as well. And I think we have
And Rachel, do we have our action?
Yeah, yeah, Chelsea's going to help out with some actions as well.
Magic penny.
Volunteer to help make our community a better place, who support justice and compassion and caring.
We ask for your blessing on all who give in so many ways.
Thank you, God, for our church family. Thank you for those who parent us in faith, who share their faith journeys with us, who help us to live faithfully, whose words and actions are filled with respect and love.
We ask your blessing on all who nurture and challenge us to live our faith.
For all the women who have wanted to have children but choose to mother everyone else.
Thank you, God, for our church family.
For all who walk
this journey with us. For those who care for us. Who seek God. Your kingdom on earth as in heaven.
Thank you, God, for our church family, and bless our many families. Amen.
And let us turn together as a family to our God who parents us as mother and father, join together in the prayer of community and love and kindness that Jesus taught as we say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Before we join in our closing hymn, I'd like to say a special thank you to Brett and to all the our children and youth for sharing with us today. And God bless you, and we are so blessed to have you with us and leading us. and guiding us with your gifts today. So thank you very much. And I do notice I missed bulletin dedications earlier. The bulletins today were donated in loving memory of mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, Laura LeGros, by son Ed, daughter-in-law Debbie, and granddaughter Christine. And the bulletin last week was in loving memory of beloved mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, Dolly Bennett. Much love from Bob, Debbie, Sherry, Gregory, Christy, and Bryn. And we gratefully acknowledge donations to the glory of God in loving memory of all the Stokes from Roger and Rosemary Richards. Friends, let us join together in our closing hymn. You may stand and sing with our Mass song for the beauty of the earth. And for those who are watching along, you may have your hymn book with you. It's number 226.
We go out to share God's gifts with the world. Go into the world and know that God blesses you.
Thanks be to God. Amen.